everyone. My name is Jess from Art with Aunt Jess. I'm super excited today because we're going to spend some time together painting these two cute paintings. Now, if you have additional kids, you might have more than two. They are meant to be hung together, and it's super duper fun. So before we get started, let's talk about the materials we're going to need. Make sure that we are prepared. The first thing you're going to need, you should have a brown paper bag that has paint in it, one for each person. Inside, there are your three primary colors, blue, red, and yellow, and then you'll also have black and white. They all have lids. These last for a long, long time, so if you end up not using all of your paint, feel free to use it on other projects. In addition to that, you should have a canvas. Each person has their own. Now, if your canvas still has the plastic on it, which some of them might, just go ahead and rip that plastic off and throw the plastic in the trash, and then your canvas is ready to go. Also, you should have a large Ziploc baggie that has a cup in it for water. You should have three paint brushes, a medium mama brush, a flathead brush, and a baby brush. We will be using all three of these. You should have a paper towel, and if you want any additional paper towels, you're welcome to use them. And then we will have a plate used as our paint palette. Now, also in that bag is my business card. If you ever want to do your own private party or something like that, I do come to you in person or I do them online. I do also teach weekly kids classes for homeschool kids and public school kids. So let's go. Okay, so getting started today, our first step is to draw our owl and branch. Okay, so that means you will need a pencil. Keep in mind when we're drawing on this canvas that it's really difficult to erase. Our canvas does have a texture, and so we're going to give ourselves guidelines. It's okay if our lines are not perfect, not perfectly straight, they're not exactly how you want. When it comes time to come paint it, we can clean up those lines, we can make them how we want. So no stress if your lines are messy. Now with that, my lines today are gonna be pretty dark so that you can see them. But you want to make your lines just dark enough so that you can see them, but light enough that it's easy to kind of fiddle with them and move them if you need, since we can't erase, and easy to paint over, okay? So keep in mind, like I said, my lines are gonna be much darker. Now I am gonna start drawing with our mama or auntie, grandma, caretaker, whoever our adult is today, and then we're gonna draw with the kiddos. Now when it comes to painting, you'll see me paint real time, the mama one or auntie or whoever, and then you'll see kind of a fast version. I'll speed it up on the kiddos because we're gonna paint at the same time. I don't want you guys to have to sit and wait while I'm doing two paintings, since there's just one painting for each of you. Okay, so let's get going. So I'm gonna be drawing with the mamas and aunties and grandmas and caretakers, and kiddos, you get to sit and be patient. Now if you have more than one kiddo, as we come back to line up our branches, we'll set all of them together and you can line up, you could have four or five kiddos and these can still hang together, okay? So I'm gonna move this over so we can mainly see this one first, okay? I have my pencil. Now, step one is to start about a quarter down from the top and I'm gonna start my line down right next to that edge, okay? Now my goal is I wanna create a nice swoop for my owl. We're having a fun kind of cartoony owl. And you can see my lines are not perfect, but that's okay. I'm giving myself those guidelines. And so our goal is to have kind of a nice big letter U. Now, especially our mamas and grandmas and aunties, you are gonna be the bigger owl. So I really want you guys to come nice and tall to the top, okay? So nice big swoop. Next step is we're gonna create our pointy owl ears. Okay, and then you're gonna connect the two ears with just a gentle swoop, okay? Again, we're going for a simple kind of cartoony owl today, and it'll be super fun when we paint it. Now, step two, so we have our nice owl here, is we're gonna come and do our big owl eyes. Now, they're gonna look abnormally big because we're gonna have a couple of layers, okay? So nice big owl eyes, okay? And then we're gonna come in and actually do a smaller circle right inside of this big circle. having about the same width all the way across. Go. Again, we're creating guidelines. It's okay if they're not perfect. In fact, I think this circle ended up a little bit bigger than that one, but that's okay. Okay. And then I want my mama or Auntie Owl to be looking at the kiddos. So we're going to have a pupil that goes to the right. Now, as we come and paint, we'll have an opportunity to add a cute, like maybe a little bit of makeup with some mascara. But right now we're just going to keep it nice and simple. Okay, step two, we want our beak, and our beak is just an upside down triangle. Okay, and then after that, we're gonna come and do our mama's belly. It's not a mouth, we're not doing a frowny face. It is a belly, and I can have my feathers be upside down or right side up. In fact, I think I'm gonna do right side up for this one. I'm not even gonna worry about that guy. I can come back and fix it when it's time to paint. We are gonna probably paint over these anyway, okay? And if I'm going too fast at any time, guys, please pause. It's one nice thing about having a recording. You can pause at any point to catch up if you feel like I'm going too fast, okay? Now, on the left here, I'm gonna come and start our wings. And it's just that nice big teardrop. And then I have one right next to it. One. Okay. And then I'll come on the right side. Nice big teardrop. And it can come in or out depending on that look you want. Again, if you end up with one a little bit smaller than the other, not a big deal. Okay. Then we're going to have some feetsies and some legs coming down. They're just going to be lines with our three lines for the feet. And this is going to help us figure out where our branch is, okay? Because we're going to start on one side, and we want a branch that's not perfectly straight. It's also not super wiggly, but it goes from one side to the other. And then down at the bottom here, it's going to sort of follow it. Maybe you have a branch that comes off of it, off on our the bottom of our canvas, okay? Now, when it comes time for kiddos to come do the branch, we're going to bring our canvases right up next to each other so that we can continue that branch. Okay? In fact, let's go ahead and do that now. So kiddos, go ahead and put your canvas right up against the big canvas, or for the big owl. And I want you to make a mark so that you know where the branches start. This is how we're going to have these work together. Okay. We don't have to do the branch all the way across, but we want to have some visualization, some spots where our branches come together. So that means that if your little kid owl is way over here or down over here or any of that, these are meant to be together. Now, with that, if you have more than one kiddo, I recommend you hang them where mama or auntie or grandma is on the left so that she's looking at the kiddos, okay? And then they will build on each other, whether you do it oldest to youngest or whoever's sitting next to you, all of that, not a big deal. Now, mama or auntie or grandma owl started closer to the right side. So now this is the kiddo's turn with the pencil. We're going to start the kiddos closer to the left because they're aiming towards the adult owl. Okay. Now our kiddos, your guys are going to be a little smaller, even if you happen to be taller than the lady in your life, the mama or grandma or auntie or caretaker, we're going to have our owl be a little bit smaller. Okay. So first step is we start on this left here. Okay. We're going to start our line to the left. And we'll do our swoop a little bit lower than our big owl, okay? And it's not gonna be quite as wide because we're not quite as big, okay? So we start that swoop a little bit to the left. Bring it up as far as you want so that you can do your owl ears. and then they meet together in the middle. Again, if it's a little bit wonky, not a big deal. Just remember, these are guidelines. This is going to show us where we want to put paint, and that's what will finalize our shapes. Okay? Now I'll come in and do our nice big owl eyes. Okay? A little bit bigger than you would expect, because remember, we're going to come in and do another line. Now, if you notice in mine, do you see how one of my eyes is much larger than the other? It's a little bit too big. So I'll come and I'll adjust this so it's not quite so big. And I'll show you, if we were to try to erase this, it kind of erases a little bit, but it more smudges it. It doesn't really erase. So I'll just remember that I'm gonna paint right over the top of that. Okay, and then I'll come in and do my second layer of circles. Okay, now at this point you can have kiddo looking at mama or grandma or auntie, or you can have a kiddo with the eyes closed. Okay, so when that happens, we will just make this part darker. And you can actually color it in with your pencil, that way you remember. And if you want your eye shut, you will paint right over the top of this top circle. So I'll go ahead and do this guy with the eyes shut, because we can see what it's going to look like with the eyes open with our adult owl. Okay. And then if it's a girl or even boys, you can have eyelashes and stuff. We can add that at the very end. Now we have our upside down triangle nose. It can be big or small. That is up to you. And then we have our belly. Okay. Again, it's not a frowny face, although it looks a little bit like a frowny face. And at the very end, we'll come and add that owl detail. Okay. Next step, let's do our wings. You might have a teardrop shape that's on the body, or they might come outside the body. Your goal is three, but if you only want two, that's okay, or if you want four. So I'll start over here, and I think maybe we'll go out a little bit with that one. Now we have our legs and our feet. Okie doke. Now at this point, you might notice I have a lot of negative space here. That's a lot of that background that doesn't have a lot of stuff because our little owl is more to the left. Well, this is an opportunity for you to create really cool branches. Okay, so let's start with our main branch. So we're starting it so that it matches up with our adult owl. It might come down or up, and then we'll follow it here. If your branch ends up thinner than mine, that's okay. Okay, or a nice big fat branch. And my owls today have a nice big fat branch to be on. Okay, but when I get to the right here, I can come up and maybe I have some smaller branches on my tree where they start out big and they get skinny. And then maybe my branch comes up a little bit. This is where you're gonna have to match up. If you have more kiddos, make sure they match up with here. And maybe this guy has a few friends that we're gonna be able to paint. It's okay if you can see the lines in between them. Again, these are guidelines, okay? And we may end up even coming back and adding some leaves to these branches. Okay, maybe I have a friend down here. And if our mama wants, maybe over here, if you decide you want a branch or something that comes up here, that you can totally do that. And maybe you have a leaf or two. So take a few moments. Again, if you need to pause or something to catch up, think about how you want your branches. Make sure that our main branches are matching up together, and figure out if you want your eyes open or closed. Again, with these closed eyes, this top inner line here, we're gonna paint right over it, okay? And also decide whether or not you want your feathers to be like happy faces or upside down letter U's, okay? So go ahead and finish up your drawing part, and then we will move on to step two. Okay, step two. So let's get set up. So for this, I'm going to go ahead and take this canvas away because I'm going to do the main painting together with the larger owl. That way you can see my paint and that kind of stuff. But this guy will come back. So kiddos, that doesn't mean that you're not painting right now. We're all going to paint together, but I'm going to mainly paint this one in real time and then I'll come back and paint this guy. It'll be super duper fast. Okie doke. So let me take that away. So let's get set up. So you are going to need your Ziploc baggie of things. Okay. Now, if you haven't done so already, go ahead and get yourself some water. I generally recommend about halfway. I already have my water here. You can see I reuse this cup lots and lots and lots. Okay. You have, we have got our paper towel out and I have my paint palette and my paint brushes. Okay, now at this point, you don't want to pour all of your paint out onto the plate, but I also do not want to use the paint directly from my cup. We want to keep the paint in the cups nice and clean because we are going to be mixing paint today, so we don't want to mess up our clean paint, okay? And you should have three paint brushes like we talked about in the beginning. Now, the first step to using any of our paint brushes is to get it ready. Now, for now, we don't need our baby brush. So we just need our mama and our flat brush. So if you have a plastic protector on your paintbrush, we're going to take that off. And you might notice that these paint brushes are somewhat stiff. We don't want to break that, okay, because then our paintbrush is not usable. So the best way to prep our brush is to put it in our water, okay? Now, if your paintbrush is super duper stiff, you can gently let it soak and you can press down gently, okay? You don't want to break the brush, but just gently, and you'll notice that it should separate and be usable, okay? Now, we want to start working on our background, okay? So for mine, I'm going to work on a background that's kind of a light blue today. We are painting background first, then we will paint our branch and our owl. And then we'll come back after our dry time and finish off some of the details and come back and add our black outlines. Okay, so first, background. Now you really can do the background in whatever color you want. So, but today I am going to be using kind of a really light blue, something like sky colored. Okay, so I'll pop the lid off of my paint and I'm gonna tap, tap, tap some paint on my plate. Now you'll see my white is kind of thin. Some of your white might be a little thicker, but be careful in pouring your paint a little bit. You can always add more, but we don't want to waste the paint if we end up not using it. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and put the lid back on so it doesn't spill. I've got that white on my canvas. You saw me kind of use my finger to scrape the rest of the paint off the edge. You can do that or not. And then I'm going to get some blue. So I will tap, tap, tap. My blue is definitely a little bit thicker, but I want a nice light blue. So I don't need super a lot of blue. And we're only gonna put paint on our plate as we use it. Now to do my background, I am gonna be using my green mama brush. Now if you get your brush and you put it in the water and it's still kind of stuck together, you may have to use your finger to separate a little bit. These are all brand new brushes and they come that way from the manufacturer sometimes, okay? So first step is we are going to mix paint. Now, some people as they mix paint like to mix paint and use their entire big giant plate, but we want to keep it somewhat contained, okay? So what that means is I'm going to pull some of my white paint over a little bit closer to my blue, okay? That way I keep a nice clean white. And I'm gonna bring some of my blue into my white. Generally speaking, when mixing color, especially if you're mixing a light color, you wanna mix the dark color into the light color. I don't know if you've ever tried to make like pink or something like that. And if you start with red and add white to it, you have to add a whole lot of white to get that to a light pink. Where if you start with your light color, you can add just a little bit of that dark paint and then just a little bit more and it stays kind of light, okay? So I'm pretty happy with this color of blue. We are going to be doing something called a dirty brush technique, which means we're not going to wash our brush. And so some of my color might end up being not just light blue. It might have little streaks of dark blue or little areas of white. Okay. Now, normally when I start a painting, sometimes I will prep my canvas with water to help my paint spread. Now, because we drew today, we didn't do that. So that might mean you need either a little bit of extra paint as you're going to get it to spread, or you might need to get a little boop of water to help your paint spread. What I mean by boop, it's a technical term, is you just barely touch the water. So you have, see how it's not dripping off my paintbrush, but it can help my paint spread. Now, I'm gonna hold my paintbrush sort of down this edge, and I'm going to spread my paint all over this background, being aware of where my edges are. Now, my goal for my background is not to have a perfectly smooth background, which that means is I don't mind if I see my paint strokes. Okay, now I don't want big giant blobs of paint, but I am okay if I have some areas lighter, darker, kind of messy fun. Now you might have noticed I picked up some white paint and just brought that in there. This is where that dirty brush comes in, because I might pick up some white paint with that light blue to have some lighter areas. I may even come and pick up just a little bit of that dark paint, that darker blue, to add some darker areas. And because the paint on my canvas is wet, it kind of mixes together. Now again, my goal is not to have a perfectly smooth background. I want to see some of my brush strokes. And I'm bringing that paint all the way to the edge. So go ahead and mix your color and start putting it on your canvas. Now, as we get closer to our owl, I do want to be aware of my line. This is an opportunity to kind of clean up some lines. So I'm going to hold my paintbrush where I have lots of control and use just the tip of that brush to help me have kind of a clean edge. And then pull away from that clean edge, because we don't want to have a perfect line showing there. Okay? We still want it to be a background that is controlled chaos. I'm sure that's probably how your household is, lots of controlled chaos. And I have a feeling that the mamas and the aunties and the grandmas and the caretakers are the ones that control the chaos. So keep working around your owl, keeping in mind the harder I push with my paintbrush, the larger my strokes will be. So if I push down really hard, I never want to smash my brush down, especially for you kiddos, never smash. But if I push much harder, I get a much larger painting area. Where if I come back and I'm just using that tip, I get a nice thin area. Okay. If you need to make more of that paint color, you may. Keeping in mind that as I go, I might pick up just some white paint and come in here and have some lighter color. I always want to pull my brush. You might notice I'm not pushing my paint. I'm always pulling, even if that means I have to turn my wrist. Maybe I'll bring some of that darker color. And again, if you're having trouble with your paint spreading, you either need more paint, you need a little bit of water. So my paint stopped spreading. And so you see, I didn't even get more paint. I just got some water on my brush and it's already spreading better. Especially with this wet on wet kind of dirty brush technique. Sometimes over the course of this larger area, my paintbrush dries out a little bit. Not dry enough that my paint is dry, but dry enough that it's not spreading very well. And I'm going back to my paint palette, we'll call it that, paint palette, which is my plate, pretty often to get more paint. If you keep painting and your paintbrush runs out of paint, it's not going to spread very well. Okay. I might pick up some more white paint, have a little bit of a lighter area here, just to kind of change it up a little bit so I can see those brush strokes. Now, as we're getting down to areas that require a little bit of a careful hand. You may find that your brush is very flat, maybe very open and wide, and it might be so full of paint that you are unable to have a tip of your brush. If that happens, I have a little something on my, there we go. Just do kind of a reset. You can take your brush, come in your water, especially if you're like 2/3 of the way through, do a reset. Don't recommend you do this over your canvas, but okay. And then I have my tip back. So when I come and pick up paint, I can come and be really careful with that tip again. Okay. And if you accidentally overlap into your owl area, don't stress, not a big deal. Especially if we have some aggressive painters, aggressive being that you're going super duper fast. A lot of times that has to, we have some kiddos who like to get things done as fast as possible, which is not a bad thing. But sometimes faster means messier. So we want to take our time. Not being afraid of seeing our brush strokes. Painting around our details. And see, I'm pulling my paint away. And I'll pull towards me. It's always pulling. You have a lot more control, and it saves your paintbrush from getting ruined. And anytime you need that reset to get the tip of that brush back, just wash your brush and then get some more paint. And if you have big blobs of paint, especially you kiddos, sometimes you guys like to use all kinds of paint, just spread them out. You don't want big giant blobs. It'll take a long time to dry, and you'll have to wait until it dries before you can move on. Now, when I get to these legs down here, I'm not going to stress if it overlaps the legs. My main concern is I don't want to cover them up so that I don't see them anymore, because we're going to come back with black at the very, very end when we come and add some of our smaller detail, and we will do our legs in black. Okay. So don't stress. I actually just kind of painted right over the top of my legs, but my paint was thin enough that I can still see them. Brush is getting a little dry again, so I'll get that little dip of water to help my paint spread. And again, if I accidentally do a boo-boo where it, maybe I got some paint down in my branch or something like that, I'm not stressed about it. And so don't forget to paint all the way around. Pulling back and forth. Maybe I'll pull a little bit of dark over in here. Now on screen, you may not be able to see some of my subtle details with my brush strokes and stuff, but I've got all kinds of fun stuff going on here. And I'm going to use that nice tip right next to my wings. We'll pull. Okay, there we go. And then we have our two areas that kind of meet up. Now, if you meet up and your colors are very, very different, mine were actually pretty similar as I met up, but you can always kind of continue painting up in this area until you have a little bit of transition. But again, our goal is not perfect smoothness, so that's okay. Now, we don't want to forget underneath our branch down here too. That also needs to be blue or whatever color you chose for your backgrounds. Might bring a little bit of darker down in here. Now, as we're painting today, you might notice that I don't paint the edges of my canvas. A lot of that's just because I'm lazy. But really, that is a choice. You can choose to paint the edges of your canvas or not. I do recommend if you choose to paint the edges that you are sure to put down that trash bag or paper or something to protect your desk because it will get messy. Okay, but to paint our edges, you're just going to lift and pull the paint from back to front. I don't recommend you paint your edges left to right because inevitably you're going to have some of the paint come over and then it's going to look different from your front. Okay, now because I am not painting the edges, I don't mind that I don't have plastic down on my my desk. Last little spot. And you can come back and clean up any spots. Maybe you missed all the way to an edge or something like that. Now, I just noticed I didn't get all the way to my top. Okay. So while you guys finish, I'm going to go ahead and fast paint my kiddos. So I'll move this guy. And paint this. So our next steps, once we have finished our background, and I am back to our big owl, but we are going to do this all together, is we are going to come and paint our belly and the lines around the eyes. Now, it seems kind of silly that I'm doing that because we're going to paint right over the top of it. But generally speaking, these here are going to be a little lighter. So, but you can do them whatever color you want. So today, I think I am going to do maybe like an orange for my belly and the lines around my eyes. Again, you can do whatever color you want. That is up to you. Okay, so I need some yellow first because we're going to make our orange. I'm going to tap, tap, tap some yellow onto my paint palette. Now, as I bring it up, you might notice that I kind of spin it to keep it clean. Okay, I'll put that lid back on. I'm going to bring some red. Okay. And I already have some white because I want to have kind of a lighter orange, I think. So I'm going to wash that mama brush to get all that blue off of there. Make sure that I'm clean. Okay. Now it's time to mix our paint. So just like we did with the light blue, whatever color you want for the detail part of your owl, that's the lines around the eyes and this belly part. You could even have the wings a different color. That's up to you. You need to figure out what color you want. Do you want pink? Do you want dark blue? Do you want green, orange, yellow? I do recommend if you decide you want yellow for around the eyes and the belly that you mix a little bit of white into it because this yellow is somewhat transparent, okay? And just that little bit of white will help it be more opaque. Today I am going to do orange. So just like we did with the light blue, I'm going to start with my lighter color and bring some over and add my darker color to it. So if I were making pink, I'd start with some white. I might need to add some more white on my plate and add some of that red to it. I want a really yellowy orange. So I already have, this is quite a dark orange. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to create this orange. It's like I'm mixing ketchup and mustard together. Okay. And then I'm going to break the rules and I'm going to bring the lighter color into it. I just want it slightly lighter. There we go. And you'll see I'm keeping my color somewhat contained towards the middle. Okay, I have an orange I like. So to get the rest of that, I don't want to use this paintbrush full of paint like this. So to get that paint out of my brush, I'm going to gently press down and spin. That like squeezes the rest of that paint out of my brush. Now, when doing detailed areas like this, I want to wash my brush and give myself a fresh brush to start with. Okay, so I'm going to wash that brush. Okay, that way I can spin my brush on my paper towel and have a fresh, nice brush. Okay, so I'm going to start painting right inside of this belly area. And paint right over the top of my pencil lines. Now you might notice, remember how I said my yellow is somewhat transparent? I can see through my paint and see my pencil lines for my swoops, which is great because now I know where I'm gonna have my swoops. Okay, so we'll just gently use in the tip of that brush. This is a great time to clean up that edge if you had kind of an unsure edge and paint in here. Now, if you still have, I mean, this blue on the outside is still a little bit wet. So if you get some blue on your brush, just go ahead and either wash your brush or you can kind of dab your paint to get that blue off of there and get some fresh paint. But don't stress. If some of your background color gets in here, not a big deal. We are going to be outlining our owls at the end. That's our last step, the details and the outlines. Okay. And I will paint in my owl's belly, giving myself a nice clean edge down here at the bottom. Now, again, I'm not going to stress that I can see my paint strokes. I'm going to come back and add some of those texture strokes by doing short strokes. Remember, our owl has feathers. So if I really focus hard and try to make it smooth, I'm gonna lose the opportunity to have some texture for my feathers. Okay, so I'll come back while my paint's wet and add those short strokes. Now, in coming in the area around the eye, I could use this brush. I could use my flat brush, okay? Because that actually gives us a nice edge, okay? Or I could come in with my baby detailed brush. Now, the problem with this detail baby brush, first of all, I haven't prepped it, so I will need to prep it, but it doesn't hold a lot of paint. And so what I find myself doing when this area is just this big is I try to blob too much paint on it, or because I have to get paint so often. So I'm actually gonna go ahead and use my flat brush because it's gonna give me a nice edge. So I'll come and I'll get some of that paint. And I am going to have it give me a nice edge. Now, if you find that your flat brush is not quite working out for you, I'm just using the tip of that brush. You can use that mama brush or you can use baby. That's up to you. You can also use this brush to the side. You get to areas where it's too thin. I will fill in the ring around the eye. Now, if you are doing a kiddo that has the eye shut, go. I will show you how to do that in just a sec. See how I angled this flat brush can actually help give me nice clean edges without that brush spreading out too much. But you use whichever paintbrush works for you. Now you might also notice this area up here, I didn't fill in all the way because it was a little bit wonky. Now when I come back, I can fix that. So I used it as a guideline and fixed it. And then later on when I come to outline it, that will go away. Okay, so I'm going to move this guy, or should I say this gal, since this is our mama, and bring in our kiddo. Okay, and let's do a different color with our kiddo. Let's go ahead and maybe do that light yellow I was talking about. Okay, so I'm going to take some of this white, mix it with my yellow. Although it's kind of funny, apparently there was some blue in there, so it's kind of a greeny yellow. Actually, I kind of like that. Happy accident. So it has just a little hair of green in there. Okay, so same thing like we did with our big owl. I'm going to use my mama brush to paint in the bottom. Great opportunity to clean up that bottom edge. And if you are already done with this whole thing, you may fast forward. Okay? And then I will come in with my other brush. Actually, I'll go ahead and continue with Mama because we're going to do the closed eyes. That's right. So if that's the case, then see, I'm going to paint right over this line. Now you might notice the line is showing. That is okay. We're going to come back with a second coat to cover up that line. And then you're just gonna leave that space where the eye is gonna have the closed eye. Okay? So I'm just using the tip of that brush. My mama brush is probably a little bit too thick. I can come in with baby or with that other flat brush. Now, as we're painting, keep in mind that that blue is wet in some places. So if you are someone that likes to have your hand or arm down flat on your paper, there's a few ways we can kind of handle this. In fact, I'm gonna go with my flat brush for this bottom part just so I have some more control. You can use your pinky in a dry spot to help keep you steady. You can have it maybe on the table or something like that. But just be sure you're not smudging paint that is already, or that is still wet. Okay, so I'm gonna sit and let that dry. Later on, if those lines on the top are still showing, I can do a second coat. So next step, let me switch the paintings again, is we need to figure out what color we want the main part of our owl. I think today on my mama, auntie, grandma owl, I think I'm gonna do red, okay? So what I'm going to do, I'll wash out that brush, and you guys can give yourself fresh water anytime you need, okay? And I'm going to use this straight red, okay? Now, again, my blue is still a little bit wet, so I'm going to be really careful with the tip of that brush. I'll start up here. Just using the tip of my brush, and then I'll clean up that edge. It was a little messy with that blue. And I'm going to paint my owl red. Now, you could choose purple, you could choose green, any color you like. All of us like different colors, so we don't all have to do the same thing. Now, if your paint is not spreading, again, you either need a little bit of water or you likely need more paint on your brush. Now, the other thing we can do, I don't know if you've noticed, but this whole time I have kept my painting straight up, but you can actually turn your painting any which way you need to be able to have control over that paintbrush and to pull your paint towards you. It is easier to have control over detail when you pull that paintbrush towards you than when you're trying to pull away. So I'm going to spread out my paint first, and then just like my bottom area, I will come back while it's wet and do those short strokes to have my feathers. So each section I do, I'll come back with the short strokes and style my feathers, because we're going to use that texture to our advantage. Now, if you're struggling with some of this detail in the smaller areas, again, you can use that baby brush at any time. But it's all about pressure. The lighter you push and you're just using the tip of that brush, the smaller your strokes will be. The harder you push with this brush, if I push all the way down, it can get pretty fat, okay? So I don't necessarily want to push as hard as I can every time. I'm also not going to stress super hard about the edges, because I'm going to come back, and again, we're going to paint black on the edges. Okay. Once I do a section, I come back and I style my feathers so that with those short strokes, so that it looks nice. Now, as I get close to these eyes, I'm gonna make sure I don't have crazy blobs of paint on my brush, and just use the tip of my brush, just barely touching. Again, you can also come in with either your flat brush or your baby brush once you have kind of filled an area, you can come back and carefully add your little strokes. And just like we did with the background, I am going to paint our mama or auntie, grandma owl in real time. And then when I come back to paint the little kiddo one, I will speed that up so you guys aren't just sitting and waiting for me. Carefully use a tip of my brush. Fill an area, come back with those short strokes to create feathers. There you go. Now, if you have a kiddo or even mama or auntie or grandma who's a little bit slower than the rest, not a big deal. Again, that's where you can come and pause the video and wait for everyone to catch up. We all work at different paces. I've had lots of students over the years, adults and kids. Some work really fast and are turbo fast painters, and some are very slow and careful and methodical. And both ways are totally fine, as long as we're not being messy. Both ways really work. So again, I paint my area. I come back with short strokes to create some nice texture for my feathers. Using the tip of my brush. And again, I am going to go ahead and turn my canvas all the way around. I am left-handed, and so it's easier for me to see those edges if I'm seeing them on the right side. If you're right-handed, you can do the opposite. The tip of my brush, I'll clean up that edge. Clean up that edge too. Fill my space with color and then come back with those short strokes to create feathers. And it's easier to pull towards you than to pull away. So I'm cleaning up those edges. Try to angle it so that your canvas makes it so your edges can be pulled towards you. So I fill my area and then I come back with my short strokes to create feathers. There we go. Again, clean up that edge. Short strokes. Now, coming into my wings, I am going to change from my mama brush to my flat brush because I have a little bit more control on those edges. But you can use mama or baby or flat brush. Okay. And I'm not going to super stress about the inside because I'm going to come back with that black paint later and outline it, but I do want to fill it all the way in. There we go. I'll do my other side as well. I have all of that covered. Now, while you guys catch up, I'm going to paint the kiddos one real quick on fast mode. So let's switch that over. Okay, and I think for them, I want to do blue. I like that light blue background. I think I'm going to do a nice dark blue for my actual owl. So I'm going to wash my brush. And then here we go. so we finish off with those wings, and that is looking good. Okay. Now, our next step is we are going to be working on our branch, and then we'll come back and do our beak. So let me switch back over to our red one. Okay. Now, let's talk about brown, okay? Because we can make brown with the colors we have right here, okay? So brown really involves all of our primary colors mixed together. So I actually already have an orange that I like. Now, if I mix in that orange with some blue, I can get some brown. Now, generally speaking, our brown is primary colors with lots of yellow. Okay, so we're going to come and create a brown that we like. And I can use the colors I already have on here. So because I already have orange and I'm kind of done with it, I'm going to move that into this area where I created that kind of greeny yellow. It's going to seem really silly and weird, but I promise you it will work. Now, if you don't have an orange or a purple or anything like that, because you could add yellow to purple, go ahead and mix either an orange or a purple or a green, and then you're going to add that last primary color into it, and it's going to look really weird for a while. Now mine turned green because I added quite a bit of blue, okay? But once this green happens, if you get a green, you definitely need to add some red. And again, brown's one of those weird colors, okay? Now I've got the start of a brown, but it's not a brown I like. It's kind of a weird looking, kind of greeny purple brown. I'm gonna add a huge dollop of yellow to this. If you have a weird brown, inevitably you need to add some yellow. Still kind of green, so I'm going to add a little bit more red. And it might take a little while for you to find a brown you like. The trick is all three primary colors. Here we go, we're getting the brown mixed together. Now, if you are starting with a color that doesn't have white in it, you might need to add some white to lighten it up. I think I'm going to add a little bit more of that red. Oop, I may have just done too much. We'll see. Actually, nope, I don't hate it. You can see I'm still keeping it somewhat contained. Okay, I'm gonna squeeze out that brush. I'm gonna wash my brush, kind of refresh it. It has all those different weirdo colors in there. Okay, and I'll see if I like this brown. That brown works. You can see it's kind of a decent brown. Now, if I were to end up starting without white, go ahead and make some other brown just to show you what it starts out with, just the primary colors. So I have yellow and some red. I will make a dark orange. This does not have white in it. That's the problem. This one had some white in there, so it made it a little bit tougher. So I make an orange. I'm going to add some blue to it. It's going to turn a weird color of green. Since I added too much blue, I do that every time. So if you got a weird color of green, not a big deal. You end up with green, add some red. And you can see I'm creating a much darker brown. Okay. I still have a little bit green, so I'm going to add some more red. And then I'm going to come back and add some yellow. I have brown. Now, don't stress if your brown doesn't look brown. Okay? Again, if your colors you're mixing is very green, add some red. If the colors you're mixing looks very purple, add some yellow. If the colors you're mixing looks very, very orange, add a little bit of blue. I always add too much blue. And mamas and aunties and grandmas, if your kiddo is having a hard time, go ahead and help them. That's okay. But I've got a lighter brown and a darker brown. I think I'm going to end up with this darker brown. I like this one. You can see it took me 2 tries until I found a brown I liked. Okay, you can kind of see my browns there. So one more time, it's all 3 primary colors to make brown. If the color you have is very green, add red. If it's very orange, add a little bit of blue. If it's very purple, add lots of yellow, okay? And inevitably, if you just have a weird color, add more yellow. It kind of works out that way, okay? Now again, before I use this, because my brush has lots and lots of color in there, but it's not mixed completely, I'm gonna go ahead and wash that brush before we end up using it. Swish it around. I like to roll it on my paper towel to get that tip back. And we're gonna come in and paint our branches. So whatever brown, green, whatever color you end up with, we're gonna come in and paint our branches. Now, just like we did short strokes to get some texture on our owl, we're gonna come in and add kind of some long strokes with this brown to help our branch. Okay, now I am painting right over the top of my bird's feet and stuff. That is okay. And clean up my edges. By this time, your blue is probably dry, so it shouldn't be too much of a big deal with cleaning up those edges, but I'm gonna do a nice long stroke. And those long strokes help our branch to have that texture. Okay. Now, as we're painting, if you want to kind of do what we did in the background with the blue and come in with some other colors, like maybe I come in with some of this lighter brown I had made, and create some areas where it changes it up a little bit. Maybe your branch has some moss and you want some green. Maybe your branch is from like a redwood, and so your branch has a little bit of red. Don't go too crazy with it. I can also bring in yellow. Maybe my branch is a little bit older, or a little bit of white would also look good. Just as I move along, I'm cleaning up those edges. I'm bringing in texture with nice long strokes. If I need a little bit of water to help my paint spread, okay. And if you're still struggling to mix brown, don't stress. Remember, it's all the primary colors. And then add some extra yellow. And you'll get something that looks okay. Now, it's also totally fine if my kiddo's branch is a much different color brown than mine. Just like it was okay if the background of my painting is a different color. Let's say kiddo decided that the background of their painting wanted pink or orange or yellow. It's okay if theirs is yellow and yours is blue, because they will still hang together very, very nicely. Okay, I'm still coming in and adding those long strokes once I've spread out my paint. Now you might notice that I did not have you get any black out. It is very tempting to come in and paint darker areas with black, but black very quickly takes over when we mix it into color. So we want to be careful with that. And see, if I wanted, I could come in with some yellow and mix it in so that I have just some different areas. If I wanted a little bit of white, you know, maybe it comes in here and changes it up a little bit, but it's all very subtle details. Okay, so that's the main part of my branch. If you have smaller branches, you can come, and this is where I would probably switch over to my baby brush. Now, I have not prepped my baby brush yet, so step one, I'm going to take off that plastic top, and then I'll need to get my baby brush wet so that it's usable. come in here for these smaller branches with my baby brush and paint them in. The trick with the baby brush also is you're not pushing crazy hard, because even though it's a little teeny baby brush, the harder you push, it's still going to spread out. But baby brushes don't hold a lot of paint all at once. So you have to go back and get paint often with the baby brush. Now up in here, you might notice that I painted kind of over that skinny branch. Now my blue is dry, so I'm just gonna paint that brown right over the blue to create my branch. And I could even extend it a little bit if I wanted. And with that, I could also create a friend. Now, if you're creating friend branches over the blue, keep in mind that all branches start as one before coming off and doing their own thing. Okay, they don't go out at a 90 degree angle. Okay, so I have this branch done, and I will come and do our kiddos. So I'm going to go back to that mama brush or my flat brush. Now I might actually need to mix a little bit more of this brown paint because I only made enough for one, but I'm going to go ahead and get started. Now, as I'm coming into these other branches, if you had some smaller branches come off, keeping in mind they all start as one, you at any point can move from mama brush to baby brush. Okay? So if your kiddo has lots of little branches, they could start with mama, but now I'm going to come in and bring that baby. And as I get to the tips of my branches, as I lift, I will have that kind of pointy tip. And see these little guys, see, I actually painted right over the top of that little branch, but it's going to start as the big branch and then come off on its own. And see, as we get to the edges and the tips of our branches, we lift and it creates tip. So maybe I even have a friend that comes up over here, and my blue is dry, so I can come right up over the top of it. Maybe he has a friend. Just every time we add a friend or a branch, they start as one branch and then we'll go off on their own. Now I also have, don't forget, I have a branch down here, so it's going to start as part of the big guy. And then we'll branch off on its own. Okay. And there we go. Okay. Now, next step is we're going to do leaves and nose. So leaves first, I definitely need some green. I don't have any green yet. If you have green, then you're good. But look at my yellow. It's looking a little rough. Now I think I can get some of my yellow off on its own, but I may need to come in with some of my fresh yellow and give myself some fresh yellow in a spot, or white or blue or whatever. As we start making these crazy colors, that's where we keep those paint in our cups. And so we always have the opportunity to have clean paint. Everyone should have plenty, plenty of paint. You probably have enough paint for an entire another painting or two. You are welcome to keep that paint and work on, and for another painting or something. Okay, so I've created this green. You can have a nice dark green or a light green. And then you're just gonna paint these leaves and it's gonna overlap the blue some, and there you go. Keeping in mind, if your leaf is right next to the brown, it might pick up a little bit of brown, but that's okay. Now you probably wanna do this with the baby brush, or mama, depends on the look of your leaves and how big your leaves are. And I can always add a leaf if I want. Maybe I want a leaf right here. Because my blue is dry, I can come back and add as many or as few leaves as I want, just right over the top of that blue. Okay, so let me go over to our mama. And we'll see if she wants some leaves. Okay, these leaves are a little smaller, so I am going to use my baby brush for it. Okay. I think I might even mix in a little bit of this blue. Make a little bit of a darker green. There we go. And then I can have nice careful edges. And it's okay that these leaves are much darker than the ones on my kiddo owl. And then one more. I'll have one more friend right here. One more leaf. Okay. So next step is our triangle nose. We need to figure out what color we want that. Now on my larger owl, I think I'm going to go for, I think I'm going to go for yellow. Okay. And so, this is again where I might need some fresh yellow, but I've got a little bit right here that's already mixed with white. But your beak can be any color you want. If you want a purple beak, that's awesome. If you want a green beak, because we're doing kind of a cartoony owl, we can get away with whatever color we want. And so, mamas and adults and grandmas and all of them, if your kiddo wants to have a green beak, your kiddo can totally have a green beak. Okay? Now, let's see. For my kiddo one, I want, I think I want a green beak. Yeah, I talked about green. I think I want green. So, I already have some green right here. I'm going to come and do a cool green beak. But if they want orange or red or pink or purple, any color you want. We just remember that to make green, it's yellow plus blue. To make orange, it's red plus yellow. And to make purple, it's red plus blue. If you want like a lavender purple, you'll just add some white to that. Okay, so we have painted the blue in the background. We have our owl mostly covered, but she's not done yet. We have our branch and our leaves, okay? Now this leads us into step 3. which we're going to take a break because we want to make sure our whole painting is dry. So what I recommend is that you take a break, maybe get a little snack for the kiddos. This is a long time to be sitting there. Get something to drink, go potty, and wait 5, 10, even as long as 20 minutes to make sure the whole painting is dry to the touch. Okay? Okay, time for step three. Now, step three, honestly, is optional. If you have a kiddo who is done and does not want to do anything further, really, there's just a little bit of step three they need to do. They don't have to outline everything, because step three really is coming in with our black to outline and finish. Okay, so if you have someone who's done, then they really need to focus on pupils if they have them, or that top part or the bottom part of the eye with it closed, the curl of their feathers down here, and the legs. And if that's all they want to do, then that is totally fine. Okay, now coming into this, I am going to be using my baby brush to finish off my outlines. Okay, and we really do want to outline everything. Again, our goal is kind of a cartoony owl. Now, we're again going to break the rules, because I said it's better to put your paint on your palette, but I'm going to go ahead and leave my black in my cup because my whole painting is dry now. I can touch the whole thing and nothing is wet, so I don't have to worry about mixing any color. And really, black does cover up most things. So as always, I am going to be outlining our bigger bird, bigger owl first, and then I'll come back and do our kiddo owl on fast forward. Okay, so we can still do this step by step together. Now, it is a good idea when outlining to start with the things in the middle and work our way outward, so we don't have any issues with getting paint on our hand. And so in this case, my center could either be my beak or my eyes. So for me, I'm gonna go ahead and start with eyes. First step being that if I have an owl with an open eye, I want to come in and paint my pupil. Now, as always with this little baby brush I'm using, the angle of the brush is important, and just using the very tip of the brush is important. If we push really hard, it will get pretty wide. And coming through all of this, our goal is the thinnest line possible. Now, it's not going to be crazy thin. It's not going to be like we used a Sharpie on it. Which you can try to do, but Sharpies don't work very well on canvases. And I'm actually going to go ahead and move my paint palette out of the way because I'm going to be turning my canvas every way I need to so that I have the best angle possible. Okay. So for example, I'm counting this as the center and I'm going to work my way outward. And so I'm going to take my time and pull towards me to start outlining my owl's eye. Just using the very tip of my brush, turning as I go. I can get more paint as I go. Okay. And coming around, taking the time to turn my canvas. Okay. So coming around, pulling towards me. It is always easier to pull toward you than push away. Pull away. And if you make a little boo-boo or something, not a big deal. But really, this step, while it does take quite a bit of patience and taking your time, finishes your painting so that it looks complete. Okay? And it's, again, all about just using the very tip of that baby brush. You can see already my eye looks more finished than it did before. Okay? So I did that circle. Now I'm going to come and outline this outer circle. And in outlining, this is my opportunity to clean up all kinds of lines. If I have some messy areas, if I have, or maybe I missed a little bit of space with the paint and there's some white showing through, you can cover all of that. Now, our lines don't have to be perfect. They don't even have to be perfectly even. Just take your time. Turn your canvas as you need. Just use the tip of that brush. You're going to get really tired of me saying use the tip of your brush. I would rather you get paint often than try to blob a bunch of paint on. And your goal is a smooth motion. I am doing little parts at a time, okay? But I am trying to pull towards me with a very smooth motion. So turning this right side up, I can also look and see if this is where I want to maybe add some makeup, mainly eyeliner on our bird, and maybe some eyelashes. You, again, don't have to do that. Not everyone wears makeup. Not everyone wants really large eyelashes. But if I do, all I'm going to do is come in and thicken this top line, which means I'm just going to push a little bit harder and make this line a little bit wider, like my little owl has something going on there. Okay, and then once I get that little bit of thickness going on, I can come, again, just the very tip of that baby brush, I can pull out and do two or three eyelashes, okay? Just using the very tip of that brush, okay? Now your eyelashes could be up a little bit or down around this about the same distance, but definitely on the side, okay? So next step, I'm gonna come to my other eye, because again, we're starting from the center and working our way out. I'm gonna start with my pupil, using the very tip of my brush. And kiddos, I know that this might get a little frustrating, but take your time, use the tip of your brush. Take breaks if you need to. Remember, you can pause this video at any time. You could even come back another day to do this step. Because we're coming straight from our cup, you just make sure you put the lid on and wash your brushes, so they're usable when you come back. Now, when we come this way, I don't want to set my hand down on that wet paint and get it on my hand. So I will turn a little bit extra so my hand is next to it, but not on it, but that I can still pull that paint towards me. Go. So now I can come back and I'm going to thicken the top part of this eye for my eyeliner. And just like regular makeup, it's okay if they don't match perfectly. Okay, and then some here, and then I'll see. I want to match about where my eyelashes are, and it comes out. There we go. Okay. Step two. Now we're going to come and outline our beak. Pretty simple, straight lines. just on the tip of that brush. And I apologize if you hear chickens in the background. My ladies have decided to use this moment to announce that they're laying their eggs. So had to do a quick pause there, but they seem to have quieted down. But if you start to hear it clucking, that's because they like to announce, I have laid my egg and I want you to cheer me on. It's very silly. So now that we've done this center part, I'm gonna come and I'm gonna do this line on the belly. Okay? Just gonna overlap the red and the orange. I might even turn this a little bit more towards me. See, we're moving this lots and lots. Pull towards me. There we go. And then this is when I can come and decide, I'm going to move it this way because I don't have any paint over here, decide if I want to have my feathers go in an upward motion or a downward motion. I have decided to go upward. So I'm going to follow kind of what I already drew. I can add more if I want. And there we go. So next step on here is we are going to come and outline the outside of our owl, except where we hit our feathers, our wings, excuse me, we're going to skip that and we'll come back and do the wings last. So when we come to do these lines, we're going to skip where our wings are and then continue. Okay. Now again, I am left-handed. So I'm going to start on this left side. If you are right-handed, you might want to start over on the right. And again, pulling towards me, I'm going to have it start this way. Using just the tip of that brush, getting paint often. The biggest mistake people make is they get frustrated because their paint's running out, and they try to put a big blob of paint on their paintbrush. And then it comes out very, very thick line. So again, I'm going to stop at the wing and skip the wing. And I'm going to come all the way down over the top of that line I already did. Okay. And you know what? If your lines are thicker than mine, that's totally fine. Again, we're going for more of a cartoony owl. And it's okay if you have bold lines. It's still going to be super duper cute. Now, as we're painting, I apologize. I know I talk so much. Some of my students laugh at me because I talk so much. But as we're painting, a few things. When we're done here, definitely give your painting a few days to fully dry and cure. And then you can seal it. Well, by sealing it, I mean you can put a varnish on it. Now, you could buy a fancy varnish at Michael's or at an art store online, but really, I find that just a simple polycrylic that you can get at like Walmart and stuff, they have a spray or they have a brush-on version, really does the job, okay? As long as you're not hanging it anywhere that's in the sun, it does great. Now, why would I want to varnish a painting? Well, two reasons. We want to varnish them because it will protect the painting from grease and dirt and cigarette smoke and all kinds of things, which can make a painting really gross and dirty. Okay? Oops, other way. And the other reason is when acrylic paint dries, it loses some of its some of its brightness and the color. I don't know if you can hear my chicken in the background. She is announcing she just laid an egg. It's hilarious. I'm going to keep going through this. We can laugh at the chickens clucking in the background. But when acrylic paint dries, it gets dull. It doesn't look quite as good as it did when it was wet. And so that varnish gives it that wet look again. So your colors will be brighter. They will look a lot better and they'll last longer. Okay, and I do recommend that you guys hang these. They're really cute when they're hung. So once we paint that outside, now I'm gonna come and outline the wings, starting with the inner one. Now, I can just do the outline and stop where they come together, or I can bring this line all the way up or part of the way up. It's kind of up to you. I think today I'm not gonna quite bring the line all the way up. I am just, I'm so laughing. We have lots of clucking chickens. They are now congratulating her for laying her egg. Yep. But I am not gonna bring my outline all the way up, just part of the way up. It's funny, we're painting a bird and I can hear the birds outside. Silly chickens. They are fun pets to have though. Okay, so I did one wing. Now I'm gonna come and do the other wing. Now it's gonna be silly, but I don't want to get paint on my hand. And so I'm gonna turn it towards the side where it's dry so that I can again pull the paint towards me, but now I have a dry spot for my hand to go. So you can turn your painting any which way, but I'm gonna outline it kind of like I did the other side where I bring the line up, but not all the way. But you can choose to just do the outline or bring the line all the way up like our original lines. That is up to you. And then finish that. Now hopefully you guys are getting pretty good at using just the tip of your brush to have nice thin lines, okay? Because now we are going to outline our branch. I forgot what that was called. I'm actually gonna turn it this way because again, I don't have to worry about getting wet paint on me if I keep it on the side that I'm using with my hand. So we're also going to outline this branch, and anytime we get to the little branches, be sure to outline the little branches too. And the leaves. So I'll come and I'll outline my leaves. Again, it gives it a nice finished edge. I'll outline this guy too. Really, this particular part, again, is completely optional. If you have a kiddo who is done, just be sure that they come back and do our bird's legs. Okay, I'm gonna have to turn to get my leaves. Continue. So with a branch, I am less stressed if my outline is perfectly straight. It is okay if it's a little wiggly, a little bumpy, some thicker in some places, thinner in some places, because really branches aren't perfectly smooth. And my chicken has decided that she did not get enough accolades. And she is clucking again. Silly girl. Okay, and then I'm gonna come over and I'm also gonna outline the bottom line. Silly chicken. I guess guess I understand it, though, because if I had laid an egg, I would want people to cheer for me, too, because that would be crazy. The outline of my branch. Now I have the option to come in and add some detail on the branch too. And really all that would be is maybe a few lines here and there, thinner, thicker. What you don't want is stripes. So remember we talked about controlled chaos earlier. So we want some lines that are just, if you do add lines, you don't have to do this part. But we want some that are uneven, some shorter, some longer, just to have a little bit of detail, okay? And then our last step is I'm gonna come in and add our legs and our feet. Hopefully you're able to kind of visualize or see where you originally had your lines, just in case you did paint over it with your brown paint and the blue paint. Okay, I'll come to my second one. Do my feet. Okay, so now at this point, I'm almost done. Really my last step, and I know I haven't outlined my kiddo's one yet, but I will in just a second. But before you walk away, really the last step is I want you to sign it. This, you have put quite a bit of yourself into it, even if you're maybe feeling a little unsure of yourself or a little unsure of if you like it or not. Really, we should be proud that we did this. And what a fun activity to do with your kiddos or nieces and nephews or grandchildren, and memories that you're creating, even if it doesn't turn out exactly like you were hoping, or maybe it turned out better than you were hoping, which is super cool. But what I recommend is at some place you come and sign it. So just like we were doing the outlining, it doesn't have to be in black, but I like black. Be sure to come and sign your initials or your name, your first name. And find a spot where you can kind of stick it in there. My initials are JL. I have signed my paintings with a heart ever since I was 10. So I always do it with a little heart. Now, speaking of hearts, if you wanted to come and add a heart into the sky or something like that, you could come and add some clouds or some extra detail, and that's totally fine. Really, it's what you make of it. You don't have to follow my directions exactly. So I'm finished with Mama. Now I'm gonna finish the kiddos real quick. And I will follow those same steps. Thank you. you finish by signing it, doing our heart if you want. Okay, take a look, make sure I didn't miss anything. Awesome, looks good. So let's go ahead and when you're done, be sure to put the lid on your paint because there is still lots and lots of paint left. Put this guy over here. Putting our mama back in. Okay, and we have our finished piece. So these are companion pieces. These are meant to be hung together. And again, if you have lots of kiddos, hopefully they kind of fit together. And if they're not perfect, that's totally fine. So, bye-bye. Thank you everyone for joining me today. I had so much fun. Hopefully you guys had fun too. If you want, I am on Facebook and Instagram. I would love to see pictures of your guys' final products, especially if they're hung together. That kind of stuff just brings me joy. And so if you'd like to send that to me, I would love that. But I hope you guys have a wonderful Mother's Day and a wonderful end of the school year. Bye!